This is the video number one of the course of conservation framing carried out by Rinaldin.
Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Mark Reynolds. I'm a bespoke conservation picture framer. I'm qualified with the Fine Art Trade Guild Certified Frames System, and I hold advanced accreditations in conservation framing and textile framing. I regularly write articles for the Fine Art Trade Guild's magazine called Art Business Today, and I am also an author writing articles and a masterclass in Arcadia's Four Walls magazine. Along with that, I am on their Ask the Experts panel, and I regularly answer questions that Arcadia customers have on conservation framing matters. I also lecture twice a year at the University of Lincoln to their undergraduates taking a honours degree in conservation of historic objects. I have been invited to Italy by Rinaldin to show to you and demonstrate some workshop practices in conservation framing. The subjects include a basic conservation introduction, followed by conservation mount packages, conservation hinging, the use of spacers, the sealing of the glass, the mount package together, and also some non-adhesive methods of supporting artwork. I hope you enjoy them. They're all of conservation level, and I hope that in the future you'll be able to use some of these practices. Works of art on paper cover a vast range, both from subject matter to value. And whilst paper is extremely durable, there are factors that actually could cause problems with paper strength. Whilst there is little we can do to completely alleviate deterioration, good conservation framing practice will actually slow the deterioration process down, and the opposite is true. Conservation framing is suitable for many different types of artwork, stretching from antique prints, limited edition prints, watercolours, and not to mention sentimental items such as photographs, papers and documents. It is of note that the final decision with regard to conservation framing is with the customer themselves. I would expect a conservation picture framer to be able to offer expert professional advice. Generally speaking, conservation picture framing has been an effective method of housing artwork for many years, providing both a buffer and a barrier, a buffer from environmental conditions and a barrier against physical damage to the object. However, in some certain circumstances, environmental conditions can cause a microclimate to occur within the picture framing and therefore cause damage. This deterioration originates primarily from fluctuations in relative humidity and temperature, light, and atmospheric gaseous pollutants. Furthermore, the use of poor quality materials and techniques will also increase the rate of degradation and deterioration of any artwork on paper. Deterioration manifests itself in several ways. It manifests itself in the discoloration and the embrittlement of paper. The ingress of dust and dirt is difficult to prevent and causes problems in that it provides a food source for pests and insects, but not only, it also provides a nuclei for atmospheric pollutants and moisture, thereby giving the correct conditions for the formation of mould. The objective of conservation framing is to visually enhance the artwork while providing protection from the aforementioned factors. Its aim is to provide that protection over a period of in excess of 20 years under normal conditions. I would now like to explain what those normal conditions are. They comprise of three elements. Firstly, out of direct sunlight. Secondly, within a temperature range of 10 degrees C to 25 degrees centigrade, and finally a relative humidity of between 40% and 60%. Let me now look at those in a little more detail. Light damage is the most pervasive and difficult to avoid. It is irreversible and it is cumulative. And the damage caused depends on two factors. Firstly, the time of exposure, and secondly, the intensity of the light source. It manifests itself in several ways. Celluloid materials bleach, yellow, and darken. They become weak and brittle, and sunlight causes pigments and dyes to fade and or change colour. For example, greens can appear blue because of the loss of the yellow tones from the green. Let me mention temperature. Temperature range between 10 degrees centigrade and 25 degrees centigrade. It is always best to keep your artwork in cool and stable conditions, and normally museums aim for a temperature of between 16 degrees centigrade and 19 degrees centigrade. But perhaps this is too restrictive for our own domestic requirements. High temperatures result in chemical reactions occurring faster. Fluctuations in temperature can cause dimensional change, leading to the cracking and flaking of paintwork, the cockling and buckling of artwork, and the damage to photographic emulsions. Finally, the relative humidity between 40% and 60%. Relative humidity is the most destructive environmental factors, and what it does, it influences and triggers many chemical reactions. It is defined as the amount of moisture in the air as to the amount of moisture the air can hold at a given temperature. Air has less capacity to hold moisture than paper. If the relative humidity of air changes, then the moisture content in paper must change as well to maintain equilibrium. As relative humidity increases, then paper will expand. And as it decreases, that paper will also contract. Low relative humidity may cause problems such as the flaking of paintings, cracking, and the warping of wood, and the possibility of desiccation of some organic materials. Whereas the main problem with high relativity, certainly above 70%, is that it forms the ideal conditions for the growth of mould and associated pest infestation. Whilst the display of framed artwork is out of the control of the framer once it leaves the workshop, some framers provide their customers with simple directions how to look after their artwork. And certainly those normal conditions that I've just mentioned should be part of that advice. By offering a conservation framing service, this will certainly enhance the picture framer's reputation. Bringing along extra customers and also some very interesting work. The Fine Art Trade Guild's certified training scheme and its advanced accreditation in conservation framing will certainly provide the knowledge and the tools for the framer to be able to practice conservation framing.
You will find all the products for conservation framing in our website.